No.
Following some late breaking news, Chesapeake CEO Aubrey McClendon has agreed to step down.
McClendon agreed to retire from the company he founded on April 1st. Naveen Dhaliwal is live with the late breaking update tonight. Naveen.
Paul and Jessica, the board did an extensive review and they say they did not find any misconduct on Aubrey McClendon's part. So that's not the reason for this decision. The board did release a statement. The chairman of the board says, by forging ahead with a new chief executive officer, the company's strong management team and talented employees will continue to develop the industry's best assets. Now, earlier today, we were at the McClendon home, and he has security around the clock. His security team told us he was not making any remarks in person. But McClendon told us in a written statement that he has philosophical differences with the new board. And then we got a copy of an email that was sent to Chesapeake employees from McClendon. It says, in many respects, our accomplishments are unique, and I will always remain immensely grateful for the time I've spent with you building Chesapeake. Now, McClendon is retiring officially on April 1st. He will remain as CEO until his successor has been appointed. Live in Oklahoma City, Naveen Dhaliwal, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
Naveen, thank you. This all comes after a year of trouble for Chesapeake and Aubrey McClendon. It all started April of last year. That's when company stocks plummeted after McClendon borrowed $1 billion against his company assets. It was followed by a federal lawsuit asking a judge to step in and look at his actions. Then it got worse in May. McClendon stepped down as chairman of the company and announced that the company was ending a controversial compensation program, a program the SEC was asked to investigate because of a possible conflict of interest by McClendon. By June, a new chairman was named. Archie Dunham is a former board member at ConocoPhillips.